So in this module, we're going to talk about equilibrium expressions involving pressure. So what's going on here is the reactants and products are gases. And if they're gases, you'll see that we can write an equilibrium expression involving the partial pressures of the gases involved. So it looks like this. So we're going to go way back, old school, to the ideal gas law, right? PV equals nRT. If we rearrange the ideal gas law a little bit, we get P equals N over V times RT, but N, remember, is moles, and V is the volume in liters. Well, moles over liters is just the molarity of, in this case, the gas. So we could say that the pressure of a gas is equal to the molarity times RT, or the molarity is equal to the pressure over RT. So we're going to use that. So going back to our general equilibrium reaction, AA plus BB goes to CC plus DD, writing down the equilibrium expression. You know, remember, sometimes we write this as a KC, but most of the time we're just going to write it K, assuming that the C is there, or it's implied. C stands for concentrations. So there we have our good old equilibrium expression. But now, instead of the concentrations, which are molarities, we're going to replace them with the pressure over RT. Because remember, we just said that P over RT is equal to the concentration. And then, so here, the pressure of gas C, now these are going to be gases, is going to be the partial pressure of that gas in the container. And we're going to raise it to the power of its coefficient. So P, the partial pressure of D over RT to the power D, and so on. And we can, what we can do here is we can pull out the RT. So this is 1 over RT to the C, 1 over RT to the D, 1 over RT to the A, 1 over RT to the B. And it ends up we get the partial pressures each raised to the powers of their coefficients from the balanced equation times 1 over RT to the delta N, where delta N is just C plus D minus A plus B. All it is, all this delta N is, it's the change in the number of moles of gases, right? So the number of moles of C plus the number of moles of D that we make, or on the product side rather, minus the moles of A plus the moles of B. So delta N. So this is a very useful equation. We can rearrange this a little bit. So the equilibrium expression involving the partial pressures, this one right here, we call K sub P, P for pressures. And it's numerically different than K or KC. We just saw that. What we just saw is that the K is equal to KP. This is KP times 1 over RT to the delta N. Oops, we'll get to there in just a second. So, or if we rearrange this, we can say KP is equal to K times RT to the delta N, where again, remember, delta N is the sum of the coefficients of the gaseous products minus the sums of the coefficients of the gaseous reactants, C plus D minus A plus B. Okay, so these are useful, remember them. So here we go. So nitrosyl chloride decomposes, this is nitrosyl chloride right here, into nitrogen monoxide and chlorine gas. These are all gases here. And so let's say if we start out with the pressure of nitrosyl chloride at 400 Kelvin in a container, where the pressure of just the nitrosyl chloride with none of the products here yet is 2.75 atmospheres. And then we let it react. We let it get to equilibrium. And then the total pressure at the same temperature in that same container after equilibrium is achieved is, say, 3.58 atmospheres. What are the values of K and KP? Well, okay, what we're going to do first is we're going to get KP and then use that relationship that we just saw to calculate K in terms of concentration. So how do we get a KP? Well, what is KP? It's the pressure of nitrogen monoxide squared times the pressure of chlorine divided by the pressure of nitrosyl chloride squared. So we need to get the partial pressure of all these gases at equilibrium. That's what we're going to do first. So let's say, okay, so we know we started with 2.75 atmospheres of nitrosyl chloride and no nitrogen monoxide or chlorine. And then at the end, we have a total of 3.58 atmospheres. So what we can say is that we started with 2.75 atmospheres of nitrosyl chloride. And if we let X be, say, how much chlorine is produced, the pressure of chlorine that's produced, because two nitrosyl chlorides decompose for every one chlorine molecule that's made, we can say that the pressure at equilibrium of nitrosyl chloride is just 2.75 minus 2 times x. And then the pressure of nitrogen monoxide is going to be 2 times x, and the pressure of chlorine is x. So the total pressure, this is really Dalton's law of partial pressures from way back, is just 2.75 atmospheres, what we started with, minus 2x, the amount of this we lost, plus 2x, the amount of this that we gained, plus x, the amount of this that we gained, which ends up just being 2.75 atmospheres plus x. These two cancel. Anyway, you solve this guy for x, and you should get 0.83 atmospheres. Please check my algebra. So now we know x, which is the partial pressure of chlorine at equilibrium, which means we know the partial pressure of nitrosyl chloride, 2.75 minus 2 times x, and the pressure of the partial pressure of nitrogen monoxide, 2 times x, 2 times 0.83. Now that we know those, we can plug into Kp. So partial pressure of nitrosyl chloride is 2.75 minus 2x is 1.1 or so atmospheres. Partial pressure of nitrogen monoxide is 2 times x, or about 1.7 atmospheres, and partial pressure of chlorine is 0.83 atmospheres, or x. Plugging these guys into here, so we're going to do 1.66 squared times 0.83 divided by 1.09 squared, and we come up with, again, check my math, get about 1.9 for Kp. All right, there's Kp. Now let's get K. Well, that's easy, right? We have this relationship. K is just Kp times 1 over RT to the delta N. What's delta N? It's the sum of the coefficients for the products, 2 plus 1, minus the coefficients for the reactant, 2. So 2 plus 1 minus 2 is just 1. So K, in this case, is 1.92 times 1 over RT to the first power. Plug this in your calculator, and I get about 0.059.